Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at a powerful new feature in Numbers, the ability to use regular expressions. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So regular expressions is something you could find in all sorts of programming languages and other places. Its ability to look for patterns in text, count them, and even replace text using those patterns. Numbers version 10.1 adds the ability to use these in a variety of different places. This is something that Microsoft Excel doesn't even have. So it's really exciting to see it in Numbers. So let's look at some examples. Here I've got a list of names here in a table, and I'm going to use regular expressions to count various things. For instance, here I'm just going to count the number of names that have the letter A in them. Now the formula is here in column B. So you can see here's the formula. It's using COUNTIF. It's looking here in this list of names. And then as the search criteria, it's going to use the new function RegEx. REGEX is usually the abbreviation for regular expressions. So you see that everywhere. Now this function in Numbers can't be used by itself. It has to be used inside of other functions like COUNTIF. In this case, the pattern I'm looking for is simply the letter A. A second parameter is whether to have it be case sensitive or ignore case. In this case, we're going to ignore case and we'll come up with a result of 8. 8 names have the letter A somewhere in them. Next, we've got the same function, but we're doing it case sensitive. So the pattern here is looking for capital A, and we only have 5 names that have a capital A in them. Note that the formula is here, but we can see it here because I'm using another new function in Numbers, formula text. That just allows me to show you the formula here in a different cell. It's very useful for tutorials like this. The third example gets into the patterns a little more. So here we can see the caret symbol and the dollar sign. Think of those as like bookends for the pattern. When you include those, it means that this pattern has to match the entire piece of text. It can't be part of it. Like here we have lowercase a. If we put the caret symbol and the dollar sign around that, the only matches we would get is if the person's name was just the letter A instead of an A appearing anywhere inside. Here it means this pattern has to be the complete piece of text. And the pattern we're looking for is backslash S, which stands for a non-space character, and then backslash lowercase s, which stands for a space character, followed by backslash capital S, a non-space character. The plus symbols here after the capital S in each case means it could be one or more of those. So one or more letters followed by a space followed by one or more letters. That's the pattern we're looking for. And that appears 10 times. It's not 12 because 2 of the names here have middle names. They don't match the pattern word space word. In this next one here, we're doing something very similar, except we put the capital letter A before the first backslash S. So the pattern now is some word beginning with the letter A and then having one or more characters after it. If we want it to be a little more complete, we may want to change that to an asterisk. A plus symbol means one or more. An asterisk means zero or more. So now we're looking for capital A followed by zero more characters followed by a space followed by one or more characters after that. That pattern is matched 3 times. But what about the last name? We could do the same thing here. We're just putting the capital letter B before the backslash S that represents the last name. We also may want to change the plus symbol here to an asterisk to say that the last name can actually just be the letter B, or it could be B followed by any number of characters. And we can see there are 4 names like that. Now we look for first name starts with A, last name starts with B. So we're just doing both of those things. And we could use the plus symbol if we want to make sure there's at least 2 characters there, or an asterisk if we want to allow just the letter A or just the letter B as the last or first name. So we have some more examples here. Here we're using the brackets, bracket AB, to represent that we could use any of the characters in that set. So instead of just the letter A or just the letter B, we'll allow either one of those. So either capital A or capital B followed by one or more, or maybe zero or more letters, then a space, and then one or more letters. So that matches 4 times. Now here's one where we're putting parentheses around the pattern. So It's looking for some number of letters, one or more, followed by a space. And then it's putting parentheses around that so it can match that pattern one or more times. So in other words, first name or maybe first name and middle name. And then it's going to look for the letter J followed by one or more letters after that. We can make it zero or more with an asterisk. So that happens one time. It's right here. As a final example, here we've got a last name that has to start with some character, but the second character needs to be either A, E, I, O, or U, and then zero more characters after that. So in other words, any name where the last name has a vowel as the second letter. So now let's look at the count matches function. This is a new function that can use regular expressions to find the number of times a pattern appears in a piece of text. So the piece of text we're going to put here in column B. And then the formula is going to be here in C. And then I'll show you the formula here in D. In this case, we're looking for the regular expression TH, just two letters, and we're seeing how many times it appears in the string. So count matches for B1, the regular expression TH, and false. We're not caring about case. And we can see that it appears three times. We have this, that, and other. TH and other is a third time. And the first time, TH matches, even though it's a capital T, because we said false for being case sensitive. In this second example here, we're going to look for the word and. But we don't want it to match the letters AND inside another word. So we're going to use backslash lowercase b to define a word boundary. So the pattern is word boundary and word boundary. So it would only match AND if it's a single word by itself. It'll work if it's the first word or the last word as well. Now we can use patterns in an interesting way to look for words that are similar to each other. So in this case, we're looking for words. So we do the backslash b on either side of this pattern, and we're looking for words that are TH and then the letters IS or AT. The pipe symbol there found on the right side of your keyboard is a OR symbol. So THIS or THAT. So we're going to count the number of times this or that appears. And here's a much more complex one. We're going to use word boundaries again, and we're going to look for backslash W, which is a word character. So in other words, not including punctuation and numbers and things. And then we're going to look for one or more of those characters. So a word of one or more characters. But we're going to use this question mark, equals, dot, asterisk, and then backslash one to basically do what's called a look ahead. So we find a word, and then this pattern says, okay, now that you've found a word, look ahead and see if you find an exact match for that word later on. If you do, count it. So in this case, it finds that twice. It finds the word one, it looks ahead and finds the word one again, and then it looks for two, doesn't find that, looks for three, finds that again. That's two now. There are two duplicate words in this piece of text. Now you can also use this on numbers. Regular expressions work on strings or pieces of text, but if you use a number, it'll just translate it into a string. So the number 99.2 gets translated into 99.2. And we could use regular expressions to search that piece of text. In this case, we're going to look for a whole number. So the pattern here is using the caret and the dollar sign to say it's got to be the entire thing. We do backslash lowercase d, which looks for digits 0 to 9, and one or more of those. If this matches that pattern, it'll give us a 1 for one match. This doesn't match the pattern because there's a period in here, which is not a digit. However, here we are looking for a decimal number. So we're looking for 0 or more digits followed by a period. We have to use backslash period since period is a special character in regular expressions. So backslash period says we really do want to look for a period. And then backslash D one or more times. So in this case 99.2 falls into that pattern. So we find one match. So this is an easy way to check for decimal numbers. Now it's more common to use regular expressions to look for things like valid email addresses. So in this case we've got a pretty complex one here. It's looking for letters A to Z or 0 to 9 or an underscore or a period or a plus or a minus. It's got to be those characters and then one or more of those followed by an at symbol and then a similar set of characters, one or more of those followed by a period and then just some letters or periods. So this will more or less match an email address. It's not perfect. I'm seeing longer ones that will take into account some more variations. But in general, this will give us a 1 if this is an email address and a 0 if it doesn't match. Here's something simpler to see. In this pattern we're looking for a word boundary and then one of these things, which is the first three letters of any month, also the common abbreviations for a month. If it can find a word in here that begins with one of these three characters, then it returns true. So it's a quick way to see if a date is within the first 6 months of the year. This is a date value here. But when we use count matches, it's going to interpret it as text to allow us to do the comparison. Now what happens if we have a date like this? Well, we can do the same thing, but instead we're going to use the month name function for the month from this date. So in other words, it's going to translate 7/1/2020 into just the word July. And then we'll search for the same thing here. So no matter what format the date is in, this one will tell us whether or not it's within the first 6 months. Now, while you can't use regex outside of things like countif and countMatches, you can use the function regex.extract. And this will actually look for a pattern and then take the result of the regular expression and give you that result. So as an example here, here's a pattern that's going to look for a word break, then the letter T, and then one or more word characters after that. So in other words, the first word it finds that starts with the letter T. And it's going to return that as the result. So in this text here, the word to is the result. Now there's a second parameter you can include if we look here, and that's the number here. So 1 is the default and that'll return the first result. 2 would return the second result. So using the same function but with comma 2 after it will give us the second result. So instead of 2 being the first word to start with T, 3 is the second word and that's the result we get here. Here's a practical example of that. We're going to look for a word that starts with the pound symbol. In other words, a hashtag. And we'll look for the first hashtag that's in this string of text. In this case, we're going to look for a word that matches one of these. In this case, it's one of the 12 months. So when we find that, we'll return that. So you can have a piece of text that contains any month in it, in any format. The first month that's found in the text will be returned here. Now you can concatenate strings and build a regular expression based on the values in other cells. So in this case, we're going to look for a word. We're using word boundaries here. But the middle part is going to be taken from this cell. So this cell is part of the regular expression. It's this, that, quick, fox with a pipe between. In other words, match this or that or quick or fox. Whichever one of these words appears first in this text, that's what we'll get as a result. And here's another example of using regex extract. And that's to look for the first set of digits and return that. And it's a way to pull the number out of some unusual text. Now the last thing I want to show you is using the substitute function. The substitute function allows you to replace things inside of text. And before you could just use it with plain text, right? You can look for a certain set of characters, replace it with another set of characters. But we can use regular expressions to find patterns and replace those. So in this case, we're looking for the pattern of a word followed by a space, followed by a word, followed by a space, followed by a word. And then we're going to produce a result based on what's found. Every time you put parentheses around something, it's called a capture group. So you capture the first word, you capture the second word, and you capture the third word. Now substitute, when used with regex, can use something like this, a dollar sign and a number, to denote the capture groups. So in this case, capture group 3 was the third word. We're going to go and say, we want to return the third word first, then the second word, then the first word. And you can see that effectively reverses these three words as the result. Here we're doing something a little different. We're looking for word space word. Now what will happen here is the first capture group will actually match the first word and the second capture group will match the second word, but everything has to match. So the first capture group is actually going to match all of the words except the last one, which will match here. So then if we say let's output the last word, then a comma character followed by a space, followed by the first match group, you get the last word, comma, and then all the rest of the words. And here's something that's a little easier to understand, I think. You're looking for a pattern where there's a word boundary, and then any of these words inside this capture group, and then a word boundary. And we're going to replace it with simply a bunch of underscores. So you can use it to, say, filter the words that appear in some text. Now I'm really just scratching the surface here. You can look up RegEx and RegEx Extract here and get some more examples in the help in Numbers. You can also see what other functions can use RegEx. Now if regular expressions look difficult, it's because they are. They're very difficult. Even experienced programmers have trouble with them. I've been coding for more than 35 years and I rarely can write a regular expression just off the top of my head. Usually I have to look in reference material and experiment. There are tons of websites that have beginner's guides and such for regular expressions. You can also go to regex101.com. In this site you can actually test out regular expressions by putting the expression at the top and some sample text at the bottom. I use this to create a lot of these examples. Sometimes it takes a lot of trial and error and reading the descriptions you get on the site on the right to figure out exactly the right pattern to use. So regular expressions really aren't going to be useful to everybody who uses Numbers because they are so difficult to use. But if you search online for terms like regex and then what you're actually looking for, like regex email addresses, you'll come up with some patterns that you can then use in your Numbers spreadsheets. I'll include this Numbers document as a download at this post at macmost.com so you can check out all of these examples. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.